Sure. Well, with an insemination cycle or intrauterine insemination or IUI, what ends up happening is the patient would call their nurse with the start of their period and then on day three come in for blood and ultrasound monitoring. We want to make sure that everything looks okay before the cycle is initiated and they would start taking medications. Generally that afternoon that they've come in for the monitoring, they get a call from their nurse explaining that the doctor has given them the go-ahead to start the cycle, or if they haven't been, the reason why. And then given their instructions for the first 4 to 5 days as far as the medication goes, the dosing of the medication, what times to take it, and when to next come back in for blood and ultrasound monitoring. So basically, at that point, the patient's usually coming in every other day, if not even possibly every day. It usually takes about 8 to 14 days for the ovaries to be stimulated well enough that we're ready to bring on ovulation with the injectable medication, such as Ovadril or HCG. And then about 36 hours after that is when the insemination takes place. They actually takes place here at RSC in the office setting, and the inseminations are generally performed by a nurse or one of the nurse practitioners. And patients can honestly expect to be here probably about a half an hour to 45 minutes that day. The insemination itself is actually kind of somewhat similar to having a pap smear done, in that a speculum is placed and a thin catheter is introduced into the uterus, so the sample can be placed high up into the uterine cavity. We then have you lie on a table with your hips slightly elevated for about 15 minutes. And after that, you're free to go. So about 2 weeks after that point is when we would have you come back in so that we can check and see if the cycle was effective.